the Ontario Progressive Conservatives tabled the bill that would make them the province's first government to override the Charter of Rights and Freedoms, chaos ensued across the aisle. The opposition protest an attempt to delay the bill.
Ms. Horvath, your name.
The speaker called out NDP members one by one and had the sergeant at arms eject them from the legislature.
All those in favor of the motion will please say aye.
Eventually, the bill was tabled and passed first reading with most of the opposition banished to the hallways.
Today was a day to show clearly whose side New Democrats are on, and we're on the side of all of those people who are completely disgusted by what this government's doing, and there are many of them.
Attorney General Carolyn Mulroney defended using the notwithstanding clause.
We are using the Charter of Rights and Freedoms to uphold the Constitution.
That, in spite of her father, former Prime Minister Brian Mulroney, yesterday saying he never liked the clause.
He was opposed to the notwithstanding clause when it was introduced, but he recognizes, and he said yesterday, that it is a tool that is a legal tool that is available for democratically elected legislatures to use.
But this legislature had to contend with a day of protest to use the clause, including from the public galleries. After two warnings, the speaker had had enough.
I'm sorry, we're going to have to clear the galleries.
Police handcuffed stragglers and escorted them out.
I'm 77 and a half years old. Go ahead, give me a record. I don't care. But I feel like I have to do whatever's humanly possible to stop this roller coaster.
That legislative roller coaster continues with debate on the bill tomorrow and a possible final vote sometime next week. Ron Charles, CBC News, Toronto.
CBC's Ontario Provincial Affairs reporter Mike Crawley joins me now from Toronto. You've covered Queen's Park for a long time, Mike. Give us a sense of how unusual today was.
Well, look, Rosemary, normally at this time of year in Toronto, if you see a big long line of people queued up around the corner for something, it's a premiere at the Toronto Film Festival. Well, today the hot ticket was question period at Queen's Park, of all things, if you can believe it. Extraordinary scenes, people wanting to be there to see this piece of legislation with the notwithstanding clause in it and to make their voices heard. So then you ended up with these scenes of people being led away in handcuffs after protesting and refusing to leave the legislature. Not something I have ever seen in my time at Queen's Park. You see politicians get kicked out,
sure.
but not ordinary people in the public gallery.
So, Mike, how much of this is about a new government and a new premier who's trying to, you know, rather forcefully impose his new agenda?
Well, from what I've heard from the people that I've talked to within the Doug Ford government, they want to keep the pedal to the metal. They want to accomplish a lot of things, and they don't mind if it rubs a few people the wrong way. So these kinds of scenes of protest, I'm actually expecting them to continue and probably to end up being about a wider variety of things. So it's not just going to be about the notwithstanding clause, but just about everything this Doug Ford government is going to do, you're going to see his opponents try to make their voices heard.
And probably better to get that stuff over in the beginning of a mandate rather than later on. Queen's Park reporter Mike Crawley in Toronto tonight. Thank you.
You're welcome.